First problem, in which of the following situations the list of the numbers involved forms an arithmetic progression and why? So we have to check whether the given situation represent an arithmetic progression or not. So let us find out. First bit, the minimum taxi fare is rupees 20 for the first kilometer. For the first kilometer, the taxi charging rupees 20 and thereafter rupees 8 for each additional kilometer. Then next, after each, as you go each kilometer adding to it, we will get rupees 8 more. So let us start. In solution, let us write what is given. Taxi fare for the first kilometer is equals to rupees 20. Then next, after each kilometer, it rises by rupees 8. So the charge is getting increased by 8 after each kilometer. So let us write taxi fares are, so 20 plus 8 is 28 28 plus 8 is 36 36 plus 8 is 44 44 plus 8 is 52 up to so on. Next, here we can write like common difference. So common difference formula is t2 minus t1. So what is this t2? t2 is the second term and t1 is the first term. Like that, third term, fourth term, fifth term. So let us do this. So d is equals to a2 minus a1. What is the second term? 28 minus 20. That is 8. Next, a3 minus a2. So what is A3? 36 minus 28. So that will be 20. That will be 8. So here we have observed that this common difference is same. That's why we can write it is an AP, arithmetic progression. As a common difference, as a difference between the two successive terms is the same, is constant, that is 8, that's why it is an arithmetic progression. Second bit, the amount of air present in a cylinder when a vacuum pump removes 1/4 of the air remaining in the cylinder at a time. So in a cylinder there is some air, so that air is getting removed. Each time they are removing 1/4 of that volume. So let us start. We don't know the amount of air present in the cylinder. So let us start. In solution, let us write, let the amount of air present in the cylinder B 1024 liters. So let this be the amount of air present in the cylinder. So first time it removes 1/4 of the air, 1/4 of 1024. So we can write 1/4 of 1024 liters. So that is 1/4 of 1024. So 4 ones are 8, 2 left, 4 5 are 20, 2 left 4, 6 are 24. So 256. Next, remaining air. Therefore, remaining air in the cylinder. Remaining air in the cylinder B, 1024 minus 256. So that will give us 14 minus 6 is 8, and 11 minus 5 is 6. 10 minus 11, 9 minus 2 is 7. So remaining air is 768. Next, at second time, it removes, so at second time, it will remove 1 by 4th of 768. 1 by 4th of 768. So that will be, that is 1 by 4 of 768. So 4 ones are, 4 of we can write into, so 4 ones are, 4 ones are, 3 left, 4 nines are 36, 4 twos are 8. So 192. Next. Therefore, remaining air in the cylinder is 768 minus 192 is equals to 8 minus 2 is 6, 16 minus 9 is 7, and 6 minus 1 is 5. So 576 is the remaining air. Next, at third time, it removes 1 by 4th of 576. Let us see. So that will be, that is 1 by 4 of 576. So 4 ones are, 4 ones are, 4 fours are, 4 fours are 16, 1 left, 4 fours are 16. So 144. Remaining air in the cylinder is 576 minus 144. That will be 6 minus 4 is 2, and 7 minus 4 is 3, 5 minus 1 is 4. So 432. Therefore, volume of air present in the cylinder after first, second, third, up to so on times. So after 1, 2, 3 times, so we can write the volumes as 1024, 768, then after that 576, after that 432, up to so on. So this is the first term, second term, third term, and fourth term. So let us find out the difference. So here D is equals to A2 minus A1. So what is A2? A2 is 768 minus 1024. So that will be 14 minus 8 is 6, 11 minus 6 is 5, and 9 minus 7 is 2. So minus 256. After that, A3 minus A2. So here A3 is 576 minus A2 is 768. 8 minus 6 is 2, and 16 minus 7 is 9, 6 minus 5 is 1 minus. Next, A4 minus A3. So A4 is 432 minus 576. 6 minus 2 is 4, 7 minus 3 is 4, and 5 minus 4 is 1. So 144. So here you can see the difference is not equal. That's why it is not in AP. Let us write. Thus, the difference between the successive terms is not the same, or you can say not constant. Therefore, given situation does not show an AP. Third bit, cost of digging a well after every meter of digging when it costs rupees 150 for the first meter and rises by rupees 50 for each subsequent meter. So let us start. So what they have given, for the first meter to dig, the cost is rupees 150, and after that, for increasing for every extra meter, there is the rupees 50 is the cost. So let us start. So what they have given, cost of digging the first meter. So that is rupees 150. Cost of digging the subsequent meters is equals to rupees 50 each. So for each subsequent or additional meter, they have to pay rupees 50 each. So that is meters and cost. For first meter, that is 150. For second, 150 plus 50. So that will be 200. Next, for 3 meters, 200 plus 50. So that will be 250. For 4, and up to so on, 250 plus 50, that will be 300, and like that up to so on. Next, we can write, therefore, the list is 150, 200, 250, and 300, up to so on. Here 150 is the first term, second term, third, fourth. So let us write D is equals to A2 minus A1. So that will be 200 minus 150. So 50. And like the same, A3 minus A2 is equals to A4 minus A3, up to so on. That will gives us. So 250 minus 200 is 50. 300 minus 250 is 50. So that is rupees 50. As you know, the common difference between these two terms and the third and fourth term is same. That's why we can say the given situation forms an AP. Fourth bit, the amount of money in the account at the end of each year when 10,000 is deposited at compound interest at 8% per annum. So per annum means per year. So after the end of year, the how much interest, compound interest means the person is getting the interest on interest. First you are saving some amount and in your account, for that you will get some interest plus interest on interest, that will be compounded after each year. So that will be, we have to calculate the amount of money. So, and after calculating that, we have to verify whether it is in AP or not. So let us start. In solution, let us write amount deposited initially. So at starting, how much amount they have deposited? 10,000. So that will be 10,000. Next, rate of interest. So rate of interest is 8% per annum. Next, for compound interest, we are having formula. That is, therefore, A is equals to P into 1 plus R by 100 whole to the power of N. So this is the formula. Yes. Year amount. So for first year, we can write principal amount is 10,000. Next, 1 plus R. R is 8 by 100 1 to the power of 1. So 10,000, 100, 1's up, 100. So 100 plus 8 is 108 by 100. So two zeros and these two zeros will get cancelled. 100 into 108, that will be 10800. Next, for the second year, we will get 10,000 into 1 plus 8 by 100 whole square. So 10,000 by 100. For square, we can write it two times. So 108 by 100. These two zeros and two zeros get cancelled, and this also get cancelled. Next, 108 and 108. Let us multiply 108 into 108. So 8 8s are 64. 8 zeros are 0, 6. 8 ones are 8. For 0, we will get 0, 0, 0. Next, for 1 into 108, we'll get 1 8 is 8, 0 is 1. 4, 6, 8 plus 8 is 16, 1, 0, 1 plus 0, 1 plus 0 is 1, 1. So, 11,664. 11,664. Next, for third year, we will get this three times. So 10,000 into 108 by 100, 108 by 100, and 108 by 100. So two zeros get cancelled, and again two zeros will get cancelled. For 108 and 108, 108 into 108 is 11664 into 108 by 100. So let us multiply 11664 into 108. So 8 4s are 32. 8 6s are 48 plus 3 is 51. 8 6s are 48 plus 5 is 53. So 8 1s are 8 plus 5 is 13. 1. 8 1s are 8 plus 1 is 9. Next 0 0 0 0. Next 1 4s are 4. 1 6s are 6. 1 6s are 6. 1 1s are 1. 1 1s are 1. So 2 1 4 plus 3 is 7. 3 plus 6 is 9. 9 plus 6 is 15. 1. 1 plus 1 is 2 and 1. So what is the answer? 1, 2, 5, 9, 7, 1, 2. As you can see, there are two zeros in the denominator. For the two zeros, we will get point after the two digits from behind. So therefore, the terms are 10,000. 10,000 is the first term. Next 10800 and 11664 and 12597.12. So this is the first term, second term, third term and fourth term, like that up to so on. So let us find out D. So here D is equals to A2 minus A1. A2 minus A1. So what is that? 10800 minus 10,000. So that will give us 800. Next, A3 minus A2. So 11664 minus 10800. Next, 4 minus 0 is 4. 6 minus 0 is 6. Next 16 minus 8 is 8. So 864. Next A4 minus A3. 12597.12. We have to minus this. So 11664.00. So 21. 7 minus 4 is 3. 9 minus 6 is 3, 15 minus 6 is 9. As you can see, it is clear that no difference is same. A2 minus A1 is 800, A3 minus A2 is 864, A4 minus A3 is 933.12. So we can write here, D is equals to A2 minus A1 is not equals to A3 minus A2 and which is not equals to A4 minus A3 up to so on. Therefore, given situation does not represent an AP.